Welcome to the 95 Degrees Podcast, a monthly podcast jam-packed for server news, interviews, and more. Today we're joined by Burner, My Dog Devil, Grimhoff, and this month's Customer of the Month guest, Godex. Everyone say hi.
Hello.
Did I hear somebody opening a beer?
Yeah, I did. Yes. I that.
Sorry for rattling.
Awesome. So, first of all, the Customer of the Month is Peruvian, but... Peruvian is not around and they don't VC anyway, so Godex was the elected by Peruvian. So a round of applause for Godex. Well done.
Yay!
And also he's relevant, so let's get a move on.
Speaking of applause, it's been a whole year since we've launched our podcast. Woo!
Woohoo!
Yeah.
No one's
So, even though it's been 13, so it doesn't make that much sense.
Yeah.
This is episode 13. So because it's been January, the shit kind of month after Christmas where everyone's moody and no one wants to do shit, and I've had stuff to do because I'm, you know, in the middle of moving house right now. We haven't really done much, but I'm still going to go through the news. So this month we did a pets competition, so we had loads of pillars people submit all their pet pictures into a channel, and then we had everyone vote for like the best pet. And Godex's Squeak the Hamster won.
Little Hamster.
Well done.
He picked
Squeak the Hamster.
It was like 1 point, wasn't it? It was quite a close.
Was
one.
It 1 point? I thought it was something
weird
than that.
It was between the was it Phased Cat Kota?
Oh yeah, Phased Cat was so cute.
It was cool, adorable. I almost voted for it. Can't betray my hamster like that.
Anyway, yeah, so Godex, what was your... Did you get a prize? I can't even remember now.
Nah, just he was the cutest pet.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't even participate. I just kept putting pictures of my animals because I like doing that.
So. Yeah, I started to do that at the end.
I mean, speaking of hamsters, I've only had hamsters in my life because my mum's allergic to the fur. Anyway, we also watched the important videos playlist. Yeah, I did a bot for text chat games such as Connect 4, Tic Tac Toe, Minesweeper.
We also added
the Pokemon bot. So every now and then, when you type, your Pokemon will level up and it will spawn a random one in. You've got to type the name in to catch it.
Certain chats, right?
My float cell's like level 43 now.
Yeah,
I
mean,
yeah,
mine levels up every time I talk.
I got a new, so I'm happy.
I think it's safe to say the highlight of the most important videos, what was it?
The most fuck.
I love refrigerators.
Yep. I love refrigerators.
Well, it wasn't important videos. So basically, a couple days ago, it wasn't an event, but we all just decided to watch another meme playlist, which was called Instantly Regret Clicking This Playlist Memes. And because we've seen like the start of it already, we decided to set it to random. So it played random videos from the playlist. And it had like 1,000 people, 1,000 videos in it. And it kept playing this one single fucking one called I Love Refrigerators. And it's a guy just walking in a refrigerator shop just saying that line. And
he
had to watch it like 7 times.
It goes so slow, you think a jump scare is going to show up.
Oh.
Wait, isn't that the same day we watched porn? Like right before that?
Yeah, we decided. I don't know whose decision that was.
It was yours.
Was it?
Oh, nice.
Yes.
How did we get to that? Oh, yeah, we're watching like audio described, weren't we? The man places his penis inside the woman's vagina.
Oh, God, no.
The video is titled Monster Cock Fight for Fucks. Anyway.
How, is that what blind people
I think so.
Yeah. See?
I think so. Can you imagine just a guy like, oh, yeah, I love this shit. This sounds amazing.
Oh, fucking hell, man.
Oh, my goodness.
Now, that was fun.
The woman reaches her climax.
This is 50 Shades of Grey, made in Western Europe.
Gosh, it was quite weird.
50
anyway,
Shades of
I enjoyed it.
I'm
one
sure you fucking did, my dog.
This
anyway,
is the one night of 95 degrees.
50 decibels of grey. There you go.
I love how we got from a Pokemon bot to audio describe porn.
Alright, let's get to it.
And we're only 5 minutes into the podcast.
Let's get to it, damn it.
Demonetized already.
Discord released an update where it's got higher quality sound, apparently. It's
and
whatever. I don't notice any difference, but it's probably better. I don't know. And
I've been getting worse connection issues.
If you, well, that's because it's winter, Grim. You live in Canada, and there's like you basically live in an igloo at this point, and yeah.
Excuse me, we've had a warm winter. It's only negative 17 today.
Oh, that's nothing. Anyway, yeah, and also if you have Nitro, you can change your Discord tag. Yeah, I just said if you're Discord Nitro.
Oh, yeah, did I just say Discord Premium as well?
Yeah,
I am totally out of it. Fucking hell.
I'll ask. I've been considering getting Nitro, but I can't really be asked. I'd rather like buy a couple games with that, to be honest.
I'm just looking at the chat right now. Canadian squad. Equal
Gas squad. Anyway, moving on. Grimhoff also gave away Cuphead to Kawaii Coffee, so congratulations to them. They've won the hardest game of 2017.
No.
What about Dark Souls?
Isn't that just meant to be?
2017.
Rage.
Dark Souls is still relevant.
I think the hardest game was, what was the guy in the pot who had to climb rocks and shit?
Get over it.
That was the hardest. That shit fucking infuriated me.
I just watched the pain in people's eyes fall down to the beginning, and you're like,
ah. I've watched about four different people watch it just so I can laugh at them when they get through that.
I watched a speedrun. Someone did that entire game in 1 minute and 29 seconds.
Fuck me, dude.
I watched someone speedrun Wii Sports Golf today, and they got the world record, so good for them.
How do you... I never even thought someone would think of doing that.
Why?
I don't know, but it's a thing. So...
Of all the speedruns to watch, I want to watch it now, though, to be fair.
Oh, back to you, Nate.
I'd love to fucking... I'd love to speedrun, like... Wii Sports Bowling, but is that even possible?
You just have to
we got a lot of strikes.
It doesn't go faster because of your score, though, does it?
If you get strikes.
Maybe before we got a life feed in
and
the
then
chat.
You have to not get a strike on the last one.
Yeah, fair enough.
Why?
Wait, why didn't you get a strike on the last one? Why wouldn't you need to get a strike on the last one?
Because if you get a strike, you get an extra 2 extra bowls, don't you?
Oh, I see. Okay, I didn't know that.
Yeah, see? Strategy.
I do like bowling, though.
Dude, he's already
and
pro,
the little
he
thing that comes up
started.
Saying, perfect game.
What's your record time?
Mine?
Yeah, on bowling. What's your speedrun time?
Oh, God. You have to watch YouTube and see. Check out my channel.
Anyway.
Sponsored by this guy's YouTube channel.
Anyway, moving on with the news. Sammy is back on the staff team. Woo! Also, Devil's
here.
On the staff team. Yeah, Sammy's not here, but Devil is.
Sammy makes a triumphant comeback, and she doesn't come back. I get promoted for some reason, and I'm here, usual.
You get promoted because you're not a dick.
Hey!
Pretty much.
Ooh.
We also did a golf night. That was fun. I can't remember much of it, actually.
It was fun. All right,
and it was also Sammy's birthday, so happy birthday to her.
Back band. Happy birthday,
back band.
Anyway, time to move on to Wrongify. So, if you didn't know, Wrongify is a game of really easy questions.
Wrong.
The catch is you have to answer the question incorrectly. So, for example, I might ask, "What color is the sky?" and you'd answer
blue.
Orange or
indigo.
The sky is made of all the colors. It's just that we see blue the most.
That's not what I was going to say. It has no colors. It's not made of all the colors. You can't even pull off a fake Grimhoff.
The reason why the sky looks blue is due to our atmosphere.
To be fair,
it's magic.
To be fair, you need the higher
it's refracting off the atmosphere. That's why sunsets appear to be red.
So welcome back to the science podcast, everyone.
Every single time.
So my favorite moment in quantum physics theory 2.0.
There isn't a 2.0.
Welcome to Green Cat.
Carry on.
All right, so who's first for Wrongify?
I'll do it since I'm the worst.
The 2.0.
All right, I was just about to call my dad Wrongify. I was about to say, all right, Wrongify, let's go.
All right.
Okay.
Ready for the most embarrassing act?
All right. 3, 2, 1.
Spaghetti.
What fruit is traditionally eaten at Wimbledon?
Spaghetti. I already said it.
Complete the fairy tale title. Three little...
dumplings.
In what sport would you use the dartboard?
Spaghetti. Oh shit, I already said that.
How many days are in January?
Four.
Are you female?
Yes.
I always knew it. What is the capital of Ireland?
Scotland.
Is a banana a fruit or a vegetable?
It's both.
Spell your name.
www.com.
What colors are ruby?
Blue. Shit, isn't it kind of blue? No, it's not.
What color is a Coca-Cola can?
Turquoise.
Name an orange vegetable.
Blue.
What do you use to eat soup?
Fork.
Name an animal that has hoofs.
Shit, snake.
Oh, you just got it. You scored 13.
Hey!
I'm sorry, nice. I just imagine, Timmy, what an orange vegetable. Blue!
Orange.
An orange vegetable. Blue!
Shitsnake. I think that's a candidate for the podcast name, actually. I'm going to write that one down.
Shitsnake.
Well, it depends what else we come up with accidentally throughout the rest of the podcast. Who the fuck knows? Yeah.
Not like last time with me.
Anyway, okay, who's next from Wrongify?
Me.
Okay, Grim, are you ready?
Just make sure to speak clearly because it's hard to understand your accent.
Okay, I'm going to try my hardest. Ready?
Today in the 90s.
Yes.
3, 2, 1. What is the tooth fairy collect?
Can you repeat that and start over completely?
Okay. Why don't you cut? Shut up.
So I got zero then? Great.
Alright, who's next? No joking. My dog, look what you've done just by going.
Alright. I didn't mean to. Fuck. I thought I muted myself.
What would you do that if you're muted anyway?
Why would you be doing that anyway?
Just so his parents are proud of him.
Oh, anyway. I need to calm down before I... Oh.
Talk, shit.
All right, go for it.
Okay. Grimhoff, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. Trois, deux, un. Name something that rhymes with cold.
Blue.
Complete the phrase, knock, knock, blank.
Chicken pie, I don't know.
What color is a pear?
Two.
Complete the phrase, apples and blank.
Pears.
What is the main ingredient in strawberries and cream?
Coconut.
Where does the queen come from?
Coconuts.
Are you supposed to get these questions right or wrong?
Right.
Name an occupation starting with S.
Fisherman.
What is a young sheep called?
Bah.
On which part of the body do you wear shoes?
On your forehead.
Which country is maple syrup associated with?
Oh, of course, Russia.
Name a country in Africa.
Russia.
What month of the year starts with D?
February.
You just ran out of time and you scored 12. Well done. I've got some rage down in Africa.
The moment you said on your forehead, I was like, somebody must.
You know, whoever joined partway through that,
you were like trying to think of the right wrong answer.
Grim, you have the sounds on.
I told you to turn the sounds on.
So I just heard name, and I'm like,
God damn it, Grim. Complete wrongifying tactics.
You know, every time we play Wrongify, I have to say the right answer in my head first, so I know I'm not saying the right answer.
Okay. Who wants to go next? Gordex, Devil?
Me. To be fair,
Devil's going.
When he got the knock-knock question, I was going to be like, it's the United States.
Okay. Are you ready, Devil? This is your time to show.
Not really. I'm slightly laughing.
What are you laughing at?
I don't know. It's Burner's thing about the United States and a slight mix of drunkenness.
Okay.
You're drunk?
Was that you opening the can?
I've already had... Yes, that was me.
I thought that was pop.
No, it's
Johnson Royal Southern England Bear.
Anyway, okay. I'm ready to go, yeah.
What the fuck, Mike? Shut up. 3, 2, 1. Where's the opposite of no?
Pineapple.
Name a creature of two legs.
Snake.
What country is champagne associated with?
Afghanistan.
What is the main ingredient in Stark Tartar?
Apples.
Where's a banana? Is a banana a fruit or a vegetable?
It's an apple.
What colour is a strawberry?
Orange.
Finish the standard. They tried to make me go to rehab. I said.
Yes.
What type of animal is Mickey Mouse?
Snake.
What do you use the washing machine for?
Drink water.
What colour is the Chinese flag?
Yellow.
Name a type of wine.
Vodka.
How many sides does a square have?
5.
What is the list made from?
Phones.
What part of the body do you wear a tie? You ran out of
head.
Oh, that was so solid. You got 13.
Oh, that's
nice. Make you literally, some of them I didn't even hear what you said.
Because it's
I was building up the fucking excitement.
Some of them I was just like,
oh my god, answer the question.
Like there was one of those where Devil, I could just hear Devil going like, oh shit, don't say the wrong thing.
Okay, Gordex and Burner, who's next?
Okay.
We'll leave Gordex.
Oh, Gordex.
Nate's last to do it, right?
I have to do it. Who's going to read mine out?
Nate didn't do it last time, remember?
Yeah, he did.
Didn't I?
Did he?
Who's got the nicest voice out of us? That's the question. Devil.
Yeah, Devil, can you read out the questions for me after these two?
Yeah, sure.
Devil's drunk, so it'll be more fun.
Oh, yeah, fair enough.
Just make sure to speak fast and uncontrollably.
Sure thing.
Okay, no problem.
Got it. Then we'll just stop to prove. Yeah.
Okay. Are you ready?
Yeah.
To rumble!
3, 2, 1. I pushed a button too early. Hold on. All right, 3, 2, 1. And wow. Go. What do you use to boil water?
Ice.
In which country would you use the word closet?
Spain.
What do you use to tell the time?
My hands.
Where's the opposite of cold?
Boiling.
Name a country starting with C.
Bolivia.
What country is Guinness associated with?
Portugal.
Name something clown wears.
Banana.
What sport is Lewis Hamilton famous for?
Boxing.
What do you do with a DVD?
Eat it.
What colour is the Facebook logo?
Brown.
Big Ben is in which country?
Jamaica.
Who makes dairy milk?
Yeah, man.
Your mum.
What type of animal is Kermit the Frog?
Beaver.
What is the opposite of left?
Up.
Is a banana a fruit or vegetable?
A banana.
He scored 15. Wow, best one so far.
Oh, shit.
Well done. Well done, impressive.
Oh my god, he's tied for second.
Ice technically boil water if it's cold enough.
Oh my god,
impressive.
Are we really going to go into this?
Okay.
Actually, no, ice can't. It'd have to be the atmospheric pressure that would have to be.
Oh, yeah, true.
I like having grim hair.
Burner.
Oh, fuck.
It is your time to shine.
Or are to you die. Ready? It's probably going to be dying. Let's do it.
Okay. 3, 2, 1, go. In which month is Movember?
December.
Spell my name.
CIT.
Name a superhero.
Fabgo.
What is the odd one out? Cat, dog, or kangaroo?
What?
What is the odd one out? Cat, dog, or kangaroo?
Neither.
Is a carrot a fruit or a vegetable?
It's a plane.
What is the main ingredient in chocolate mousse?
Mousse?
Finish the song lyrics. Have yourself a merry little blank.
Sock.
What is the opposite of slow?
Gotta go fast.
What do you use to
say? Oh, no, wait,
email?
Oh, fuck.
How's it
Oh, damn it, knife.
Where's wine made from?
Feet.
Oh, okay, your score was...
Oh, that was poor. That was poor.
Okay, so I blame my dog for putting me off at the start there.
Yeah.
Just by going...
What did I do?
You went meh at the start.
Yeah, like, you know how hockey rinks start? Like, you go, meh.
You sound more like a ostrich trying to speak.
I was actually kind of disappointed with Verna for the have yourself a merry little, because you're so creative and you went for...
I gotta respond ASAP. I don't have time to think.
I know.
Well, you managed to think of God.
You come
go
up with weird stuff quite quick.
Anyway,
you managed to think of what?
No, but right after I said gotta go fast, I was like, oh shit, that's all. Oh, no.
All right, guys. Okay, we know whose turn it is now.
Wait, what did he get?
Brandon got 10.
Oh, okay,
not too bad.
That was my poorest so far. The biggest one.
That's right.
Okay, let me have a drink before it's my go.
Actually, let me check. Is it 13? Let me check.
Is Devil Rude again?
Yeah, I'm really getting
humans.
Oh, that's 12. 12 is the best. 12 is the best.
All right, Nathaniel, have you had your drink?
I have had my drink.
All right. May I ask everyone else on the podcast to be quiet?
I'm going to cover my eyes so I can focus as much as I can.
You have your rectum.
I'm closing my eyes so I can concentrate.
Prepare a directum.
Wait, who said that? I thought Devil said that, but he's reading the question, so that'd be a bit shit.
We are starting in three.
Sorry.
Guys, I need to concentrate.
Democrat.
What did I do?
Stupid gifts in. This is what I told you.
Silence in
the text chat.
Sorry.
Devil.
So, silence in the podcast.
All right, go for it.
3, 2, 1. What noise does a sheep make?
Boo!
Who is married to Jay-Z?
John Cena.
What is pistachio a type of?
Come.
What type of animal is a poodle?
A cat.
Name something that rhymes with year.
Week.
What colour is an apple?
Orange.
What day is it?
Wednesday, my dudes.
Which boy won a gold ticket to the chocolate factory?
Me.
Which is the odd one out? Cat, dog, or kangaroo?
Cat.
What is a 90 degree angle?
A Discord server.
In which country would you find the Grand Canyon?
South Africa.
What does a manicurist look after?
Your eye sockets.
Name a type of German car.
Bugatti.
What color is a flamingo?
Orange.
All right, you scored 14.
Yes,
ooh.
I think I did really well there.
Who wants to hear the cool fact about the flamingo color?
Orange,
though. We do
cool facts with grins.
Somebody experiment.
Don't take this away from me.
No, they can only really be pink or blue unless you poison them to death, which I don't think counts.
God fucking damn it, Grim.
I mean, technically, any animal could be anything, because you could dye it. It's really fucking unhealthy.
Did you know the hardest color for an animal to be is blue?
Interesting.
Like, even their eyes, they're not really blue, they're more of just...
Well, mine are brown.
Do you know a manta shrimp can see 6 different hues of colors?
Ooh.
Yes, and a butterfly, I think, can either see 12 or 16, I can't remember.
What if there was, like, more colours than we know, but we wouldn't be able to...
There are.
What, like, oh, yeah, I know.
That's what we're talking about.
But
did you know we have a deadline?
What if there was, like, more colours than we thought we knew, but we couldn't find that out because there's more fucking... Because we can't see them. I don't know.
There are. What are you on about?
Is this...
Oh, okay.
Have you
never
heard the
this.
Spectrum of light?
Yeah,
oh,
like,
no.
Actually, the spectrum, which goes around like a radio.
What if there was more?
Okay.
That is basically what would happen if we saw those colors.
Okay, I know the guys who are going to be watching the video later don't see this shit, but the chat just cancels right
okay,
now.
Okay, what if there was more colors than even that, though, but no one... Like,
there
even,
is!
How would you know, though?
There are colors.
How do they know?
Science!
You can't...
We have the full... Okay, I'm looking this up and
but
putting it in the chat
more than
that?
It. But
we can't, didn't happen.
But we can't
picks
research it
happen.
Because there's no animals that can prove it.
Devil, that thing looks like it came out of a caramel pudding and
Jesus
was okay. given a brain.
Shut
okay,
up,
let's focus now.
Okay. I don't... Here you go. I'm putting it in.
Okay. But what if there was more than that, but we didn't know, but we couldn't detect it? Well, then why is that not the full scale then, is it?
That's the entire fucking point of that diagram.
Yeah, but if there was more than 100...
That little smidgen.
If there was more than even that, how would we know? That's not the full scale, Grim.
Nave. There's a thing called visible light, and everything else is spacey stuff we can not see with our eyes.
Can I just say... Some people have an eye condition that allows them to see infrared
light. Right below fucking Pikachu.
They're, the little, the thing in their eye that's protected from infrared light, that gets destroyed and the doctor has to take it out and they get an artificial one put in. Oh. But they can still see part of the infrared light, so when they look at flowers, they can see a little bit of the infrared.
She's got to the point where we're making our own
look, by look, looking it's at an interesting part.
Pikachu is twerking while you guys...
Guys, it's an interesting topic.
I think Nate has just given up at this point.
Guys,
I can't. It's an interesting
topic and all that, but we do realize we have only half an hour left, right?
I can't convey what I'm trying to say.
Okay, see those little arrows at the end of the graph?
Oh my god.
Grim, can you do this for after it?
So does
it? We don't know.
Okay, so does. Okay, right. So. How would we research things that we can't see on no one putting?
You have to, like, this is energy. Once it reaches a certain point, that's as far as it goes. It's like once you reach the speed of light.
How about...
First we had the chicken and the egg, now we have this. About it.
Stop putting pieces of Pikachu twerking and Ash!
Oh Jesus.
Stop it! All of you! I swear to God.
Okay, Nate, let's just move on. Let's move on right
let's
now.
Move the fuck on.
I'm so sorry for everyone who's listening to it on YouTube.
I had like gravitational time dilation all set
up. Stop it, we got half an hour left.
iTunes and...
Blame Nate for not understanding basic science. Okay, you learned in 5.
Because you can't stop it. Now fucking move on.
Okay. Shush. Go.
It even says human eye response.
Moving on.
Okay, I'm adding human eye response to the list of possible podcast names.
And you should add twerking Ash and fucking...
don't say twerking Ash.
One, and said it as the fucking thumbnail.
If I put twerking Ash, you won't get monetized.
Twerking isn't a demonetization thing.
No, yeah, he said twerking Ash and fucking Pikachu. They don't monetize
in the first place. I'm not old enough to get YouTube money.
I love the fact that Pikachu went from twerking with him to just taking...
We went from Wrongify to colours of the fucking
because
spectrum
of you.
To fucking Pikachu twerking.
Anyway,
you're the one continuing it. You're the one continuing it.
Holy shit. What is wrong with you lot?
Bring me into your nonsensory.
Oh god, it's gonna get worse. I have to ask if water is wet later. Before we start, we've got Witchy Rather to do first.
Then let's do a drama.
Okay, so first off, would you rather have a horrible short-term memory or horrible long-term memory? So, like, you forget.
So,
would you rather be
both
long-term?
So, would you rather be like you'd remember everything that just happened, but you forget everything else?
I have both.
I'd have horrible short-term, just so like
short-term
write things down as I'm hearing them, so I can always look at my notepad and be like, "Oh, I can't say
stuff."
Right.
Right. So,
I'd rather the 51st date.
Long-term. Long-term doesn't really benefit you much. Anything with Adam Sandler is automatically...
But it had a really hot woman, I mean...
Well, yeah, but she couldn't remember anything that happened.
It's not like Jack and Jill, where the really hot woman wasn't hot and was actually Adam Sandler.
That's my mom.
We'll be right back.
Anyway, so I don't know. Short-term memory is like you forget everything that you're just doing. So like when you walk into a room and you forgot what you did, that's that. But horrible long-term memory is like you can't. So like horrible long-term memory is like you forget everything from like your childhood and shit like that.
Oh, I had that already.
Oh, in that case, long-term.
Long-term. I got them mixed up.
Yeah.
I have short-term memory, so I'll take short-term because it's what my daily life is like anyway.
You basically need like short-term memory to basically fucking function.
Function,
like,
yeah.
Ooh, look, like, castle.
Well, there are degrees of short-term memory.
Like, oh, hey, castle.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't forget everything within 15 seconds. I forget everything pretty much a week.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's natural. Yeah, that's what humans do. That's natural.
Well, yeah, but we're talking about extreme, like...
Like, I'm talking, like, I'm forgetting things completely. Like, it doesn't exist in my head. I can't...
That's what forgetting is.
Yeah.
I know. if someone were to talk about it to you, it might help your brain. You will remember something.
That means you still have it in your brain. It's just there's nothing connecting to it because there wasn't enough information to connect it.
The brain considered it non-useful.
That's why people can remember the occupation Baker, but not the last name Baker.
No, we're going to be here for an entire hour discussing psychology.
We've really got to stop asking questions which are to do with, like, science shit.
especially when Grim is here.
Okay, let's go from science to superpowers. Would you rather be completely invisible for one day or be able to fly for one day?
Only one day? Come on.
Well, if the invisibility would be less bad, because could you imagine if the flying ran out when you were in the air?
Oh, yeah.
Could we just don't fly for 24 hours solid?
Bro, invisibility.
Why wouldn't you? Make use of all that time you got.
You can get back on the 24-hour, you're just going
to fly. And then fall to your death in a crazy glory.
I'd go invisible and go in women's lockers.
Yeah, of course you would.
And after my daughter received that sexual harassment lawsuit.
But for like,
hey, they can't put a lawsuit on someone they can't see.
Yeah,
you're only invisible for one day.
We get away with it.
It's not good if it's on the moon.
So
so I can still shit.
I feel like invisible is only more useful long term. Like,
wait, how fast can you fly?
Short term, you just want to. Don't you? Wouldn't you just want to be able to fly?
Hold on. Let me just go to Dave.
Yes, Devil. I mean, not Devil, sorry, Burner.
go to the moon for that shit, you're only for one day invisible, not 3 weeks.
I was going to say, if you could fly, you could go up to fucking the Tesla Roadster and just steal that and then drive it back home.
You have the ability to fly, not to breathe in space.
Oh, yeah, shit.
Plus, flying you can't fly in space because flying involves going through a gas of some sort.
I was gonna say, other than that, if you could fly up to the car and back in like 10 seconds, you could just hold your breath.
Do you know what the name for flying in space is?
Even though there's no oxygen, then you'd probably die.
It's space flight.
Are there any like non-pervy or criminal reasons to be invisible?
Yeah, yes. Like you could go to Area 51 and see all the top secret.
Criminal or cosplay.
Criminal.
It's not criminal.
You're not a criminal.
It's not a crime if no one knows you did it.
Nathan, two questions.
Paranoid about it, you know, people entering that. That's not
how fast can you fly, and do your clothes turn invisible when you're invisible?
Okay, your clothes would obviously turn invisible. Well, it doesn't matter. You could just walk around naked.
You turn invisible.
Yeah, but then what happens when your invisibility runs out?
Then you get arrested.
If your clothes turn invisible, then really great Fantastic Four cosplay right there.
In terms of how fast
if you
can
fly really fast, you can fly so fast that the day never ends, like that episode of Phineas and Ferb.
Oh, yeah. Superman thing.
And then you realize that shit does not exist and you face plan against the wall.
I do think that if you did have the ability to fly in this situation, it wouldn't have like a speed limit. You could just go wherever the fuck you want.
Oh, so I could just fly to another galaxy?
You can't breathe in space.
Yeah, that's what Grim said. You can't breathe in space.
You get the momentum and shoot straight forward, retrograde around the planet to get enough speed, and then go towards your destination.
We're back to science.
Well, you don't have to. If you have an infinite source of boost or speed, you don't have to.
Flight.
Well, but he's...
You cannot fly in space.
You have an infinite...
Think of a glider.
Somebody mute Dog in the Grim.
A glider is useless in space because there's no air to generate lift to allow it to fly. Shut up, Devil.
Devil, stop putting piss in. That was like a face bomb.
I'm just trying to demonstrate my feeling of the scientific.
Yeah, I think we all feel that way. Let's move on. Would you rather be unable to use search engines or unable to use social media?
Social media.
Fuck social media.
Yeah, honest. Oh, fuck off. Hey, this fucking channel.
Wait, does that include Discord though?
Thanks a lot.
Yes. I think Discord.
If we can't use Discord, then how do we?
Discord is
the
social media.
Yeah. To be fair though, like fucking.
So
you can like get search engines. Like you can get a Discord Google bot. So that you can technically cheat it.
You ask a bunch of people around the world, and it would generate the same amount of search results as Google, and then you just pick the one that comes up the most.
I mean, without social media, there'd be no memes, and without memes, what would we do?
Exactly.
Actually, don't you search out
memes? Just kill each other.
Without the Connect 4 memes, like, Burner lives for Connect 4 memes. He would have no way of going on.
I don't live for Cat 4, right? I don't live for that shit. I just really enjoy it because Nature finds really good ones.
Okay, so would you rather be infamous in history books or be forgotten after your death?
Infamous.
I want to be forgotten. I don't give a shit.
Kill them all.
No, Nave.
I don't really care.
It's not necessary to be recognized, but just that I did something.
I don't like attention.
You're going to be dead. I'm glad people know me.
You want to call us the next Ice Age.
I know how to. There's two really easy ways.
Go on then. Dave.
Really easy.
Dave, to call us the Ice Age right now.
Why do I feel like you're just going to go to the ice caps and just a little...
One is to melt a large ice cap that's near the North Atlantic Current, causing it to stop. And another one is to... make a lake, like, burst open one side of it where it's really close to the ocean and make it do the same thing to the North Atlantic Current.
This is really easy for a billionaire.
It only costs $10,000 to do both of them.
How would you
know? To cause an ice age? That's really cheap.
How do you know all this, Grim?
Because this it was my project. For,
are you going to do this right now?
It was my science fair project one year in school and the teachers
were like
greatly
telemarketing.
Concerned.
Nafe.
He's trying to give us the benefits of making an ice age.
Nate, can I give you a really clear answer on that one that you asked? How does he know all this? He is a college degree psychopath. There.
Can we? Yeah. If you cause an ice age, Grim, can we reenact the animated movie?
God damn.
I'm definitely Manny.
Let's just reenact the emoji movie with bombs. I'll be the fucking squirrel.
Someone needs to voice me, so...
Oh, hell no.
Voice me.
No.
Technically, aren't we due for an ice age right now?
Oh, yeah, we're 100,000 or so years overdue.
Yeah. It's weird, because we got that, and we've got Yellowstone. It's overdue, isn't it?
Yeah, but global warming's kind of, like, you know, heating us up, so it won't happen.
Yellowstone would be cool, because that means the end of all
that's
and everything.
When you say global warming, it would actually cause an ice age.
Just saying.
Because not only would Yellowstone if it erupted, the eruption would cause earthquakes at great, great magnitudes, which would cause other volcanoes, which would make us go into a giant...
Imagine seeing that, though. How cool would that be?
Yeah, that sounds like fun.
Okay, everybody hold. No. So basically,
we can't do that.
So basically,
that's not an easy method for, volcanic eruption.
Not going too much into scientific, but basically the volcano eruption would cover basically half the Earth at least with a cloud.
The eruption from Yellowstone would only cover most of the West Coast. And
I mean the Yellowstone would make a chain link and then other volcanoes would erupt.
Well, it would cause an ice age. That's why people are so afraid of it.
There you go, Grim.
So if we had an ice age and then the Yellowstone thing happened, it would remove that ice age and make a new one.
No, just double it. It would just stack on top.
Double
it.
Double, triple, quadruple, depends how much it erupts.
Double Ice Age. Yeah.
Sounds like a really shitty made movie.
Sharknado.
Just imagine if it gets multiplied by a sextillion and I'm just going to call it the Sex Age.
Sex Age.
Just to clarify, I'd actually rather play Sid the Sloth than the... Yikes.
Could you imagine being known as the man who caused the ice age?
That'd be awesome.
I know.
The infamous Grimoire.
I would love to be known as the person who ended humanity.
Very much.
Like, the name Jordan would no longer be used in human history.
Well,
No one would be alive to
maybe
know.
Maybe the aliens who are totally watching us right now would.
Yeah, you wouldn't be remembering it for me if you killed everyone.
Bro, can you imagine, that, though? Can you imagine the aliens watching us right now? They'd be like, oh, fucking idiot.
They figured out we're technologically advanced enough that we would survive an ice age. A lot of people would die, but we'd still survive as a species.
The aliens could be listening to us now, and they're like, yes, we're going to make an ice age to wipe out the world.
The aliens listen to the 95 Degrees podcast.
Oh, hell yeah, they do.
The ice age isn't instantaneous, so even if we didn't have the seed vault with almost every single plant in it, we'd still have the time.
Actually, the seed vault right now is in a lot of danger.
I know, it got fucked over.
Okay. Yeah, it got a bunch of water poured into it, and it's frozen over.
Hold on, people. I'm just going to be like, devil, just imagine this, like, just they're in their spaceship, and they're like, hey, boss, I'm reading some weird shit over here.
Can we fucking move on now?
Something called a podcast.
Let's move on. Fucking hell.
Yeah, let's just do it.
I think we debated that for like 10 minutes straight.
Anyway, probably, yeah.
Pretty much.
Search engines of social media to fucking... Oh, no, it wasn't that. It was history books.
Get a move on.
I can't even hang on my podcast. God, I swear to God.
Okay, Nate, let's move on.
Would you rather be an amazing painter or a brilliant mathematician?
Amazing
brilliant mathematician.
Amazing brilliant mathematician. Get some money through
what's the
that.
Point? What's the point of being a mathematician? Remember. That's what a calculator's for.
Mathematician.
No, no. If you're a brilliant mathematician, you can basically see how the universe works.
Yeah, no,
that's called a scientist.
A mathematician is a scientist. Math is fucking...
Well, then why is it all science? It should be one.
Math is the language of science.
If you're American, then Ajit Pai is banning all porn. You can draw the perfect.
Yeah, you can draw the perfect 2D porn.
Hentai, it's called.
Little Grim, just a short answer. So what?
Well, I'm gonna play some porn here. I'm gonna
play some porn here. We understand the universe. So what?
You don't want to understand it, because then you've got nothing left to try and work out.
Exactly. Look,
no, if you're never nothing left.
If you're an excellent painter, that's great and all. But you're not going to get any money out of it, because we all know artists don't get any money.
Have you seen art? I swear, like, art galleries put up, like, blank paintings, and everyone's like, oh my god, $10 billion on that shit right now.
Yeah, but
I
should mean
it's the artist's name.
So okay, let's think of it this way. Painter. Mathematicians can draw mathematical, what are they called? Those weird shapes.
Formulas?
Using math.
If I was a jizz on a canvas, someone will buy it.
Yeah,
yes. If you had a pocket knife.
I feel like that needs to be quoted.
It's not the painting, it's the artist behind it. Grim. That's why they price it up so much.
Let me give you the reality of today when it comes to that.
Geometric shapes.
He can make those shapes, and he didn't get jack shit for it.
Yeah,
I'm just gonna say, being an excellent mathematician as well, you can go to university or college for Americans, and you can get like a maths degree and like a really good maths degree, and that's fucking great. But you're still not gonna get employed after college because no one's gonna employ you back.
But if you understand math, you can understand any field of science if you're high enough in the language of math, which can get you into many jobs that pay you more than an average job. You can go into physics, you can go into engineering, you can go into a whole load of shit with a degree in math.
And how long do you think it will take before the answer?
We already answered. It's just now people are complaining we're not answering correctly, which is weird because it's an opinion question.
How much do we have left to get through? Because we're just going so slow.
Yeah, can we... You lot keep going on.
Supposed to be a fun game? We're just over-explaining it.
I don't think I ever want Grim and my dog to be in a podcast together.
Yeah.
I left. No, Grim. Okay, so welcome back, Grim. I realised today that today in America, I think, it's National Pizza Day today.
Whoa.
So I polled everyone and I asked, what's your favourite topping? So I googled the top 8 or so pizza toppings. I took out extra cheese because that's not really a fucking topping.
No.
And,
whoa.
Yes, it is.
So extra cheese. No, it doesn't count. Why
and so I polled everyone.
That shit does not count.
So 46 people said pepperoni was their favorite topping. 40 people said mushrooms. 10 people said onions.
I said anchovies.
21 people said sausage. 29 said bacon. 14 said black olives, which are... Ooh. 7 people said green peppers. 8 people said pineapple. Ugh. And
no, people said other. You're looking at the wrong thing here. You're looking at the 15 choice.
15 people said pineapple, 24 said other. My bad.
It's such an American sort of thing to have, isn't it? National Pizza Day.
Yeah.
Like, a day... But,
I had pizza yesterday. I had pepperoni pizza yesterday, so I really got my
day. Yeah, I'm pepperoni pizza tomorrow, actually.
I'm one of these people that, with pizza, to be honest, you can stick whatever the hell you want on it. I'll just eat it anyway.
You could literally, you could literally put salad.
Don't knock it, pizza. Don't knock it, Grim.
Actually, you can eat penis. You can eat duck penis.
I mean, there was literally a gift from Brett and Lude where someone was fucking a girl through a bull pizza. Penis. They cut a hole
Let's
inside
continue.
The pizza. I was just saying.
Oh.
So,
God, you guys go off on tangents a lot.
So yeah, I just thought I'd you know, mention the fact that there was a.
Yeah, why are you going on a tangent, God?
So, questions of the week. Other than that. Oh, first of all, is water wet?
No. Scientifically, it is not.
Before we get started.
Let's all agree that it's not.
Before.
Let's all agree that it's not.
Okay, so we did a vote for this one as well. 37 people. 37 people said yes. 48 people said no. Go. Debate it.
37 people are wrong.
They weren't even encouraging this.
There is no debate.
Can I say what I think?
Why are we doing this?
Okay. Is hydrogen wet?
Oh.
No.
No, that's it. I'm out.
No. No. Combine them together and you get not wet. Unless two negatives equal a positive.
We've actually got really good arguments, but we just can't say them because we don't have the energy to fight Grim and my dog.
Wait, what is wet? What do you mean by that?
And plus, they will just deny everything we say.
Yeah,
so,
exactly.
You know. Because when you touch it,
you'll make wet.
Okay.
We it goes into a sponge. That's all it does. I don't know if that's defined as wet.
Well, you are made wet by water, so in that sense, it is wet because it wets you, but it's not wet in itself as a substance.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's two different meanings of the
word. It's wetifying.
Yeah.
So what about 37 people who disagree?
Okay, voila, are we fucking done?
Wetifying.
Shush.
No, I am not shush. Before I send my fucking nukes to your house, all right? Jesus.
We actually agree on that. It was really
weird. Country doesn't have any nukes. What are you talking about?
Okay.
Your nukes.
Oh. That are owned by us.
Capital city that's possibly going to blow up because you cannot maintain your own rockets. Thank you.
Canada doesn't have nukes. We have compliments.
Is okay. Twix or Kit Kats? 49 people said Twix. 75 said Kit Kat.
Hey. I'm cutting you all off right now, okay? Twix is my favorite chocolate. Okay.
Yes. Same.
I'm not saying I'm not saying Twix sucks, but out of the two, I would say Kit Kat.
Kit Kat is so basic. There's so many chocolate.
I mean, Kit Kat were my favorite, but literally since Brexit, they've had to change the recipe so that there's less sugar in it. Literally because of Brexit.
Politics.
It's literally because of Brexit. So I've had to change to Twix because I like caramel. I love biscuits, and it's literally both.
See, I do love Twixes, but I do love Kit Kats. But the best Kit Kats are the Kit Kat Chunkies because they're
better than just regular
Kit Kats.
I don't eat regular Kit Kats.
On top of that, better than Kit Kat Chunkies are the cookie dough Kit Kat Chunkies. There we go.
Oh, I haven't seen those yet. I need to get
really
those.
Good. Double. Yeah. Ever since Brexit, the bloody British Parliament.
Jeez.
Anyway, move on.
Anyway. Okay, so yeah, literally because of Brexit, I've had to change mine, but yeah, I do like Twix. And also, it feels like you get more because there's two. Anyway, because you eat one, and it's like, oh, that was so good. Oh, wait, there's another. Whoa!
But wait, there's more.
okay, so.
He's here with the Twix.
The last question of the week that we've asked was, have you ever been on a plane? 74 people said yes, 20 said no. If this turns into a debate, I'll be amazed.
I've been on a plane. That's all I have to say.
I'm just gonna say if I ever was on a plane, I was way too young to remember.
What's your snake?
I mean, I was on a plane a month ago. Have you been on the plane?
What?
Have you been on the plane?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I've been on the plane multiple times.
I've never been outside Europe, but...
So apparently, I don't know, has anyone else in here been on a plane?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Have you guys ever experienced on takeoff the popping in your ears? Because I never have.
Yeah, that's everyone does.
I had a hole in my ear, which relieved the pressure, I never got that.
Ooh. I mean, when I was 13, I flew a plane.
You flew a plane?
Yeah, you can fly Cessnas and whatnot.
Yeah. Yeah. Did you know Cessnas use PT-6 aircraft?
My bad.
And I flew a Viking glider as well, which is pretty cool.
Fucking hell.
I got it all through the RAF training. It was
You fly a plane when you're 13?
Because I did RAF training in my school.
You don't need a license to fly an ultralight.
Okay, I'm just going to cut you guys off. I'm just looking at the chat. It's actually a really good question. Is that also a subway, is the sound with the ears?
Sometimes, it depends.
I've never had that.
I've never been in subways, honestly.
I've burped before and had that
I've
sound.
I've been in subways before, but cannot compare it because...
Are you talking like a subway's the sandwich place or like underground trains?
Underground.
Okay. God. Are you actually saying this? I know Americans are like slightly below us, but like, come on.
What do you mean slightly below me?
Wait.
Because the position, right? Because the altitude.
Let us correct that. It's a very little below us.
I'm at water level. I can't say anything.
Sorry, dog.
I can't say. You just drowned.
Water level.
Just drowns. Okay, well.
I can literally, like, 20 years. This where I'm at now will be gone.
Yeah, I can honestly say I've never bought a sandwich and had my ears pop while I do it. So.
Yeah, I've actually never had a Subway. I've never had a Subway because I like my sandwiches literally just either with butter or with cheese.
It's also gives you diarrhea.
You ever noticed though? Have you ever gone to someone for the first time and never understand when they're asked if they want it cheese and toasted? I found every time I go, someone will say cheese and toast and they'll get all confused, like it's the hardest decision they'll ever make.
Actually, guys, come to think of it, isn't air pressure basically the main reason for the pop?
Yeah. No.
Then technically a subway is a should happen, right?
How deep is the subway?
I haven't been on an underground.
I don't fucking know.
I don't know what the London Underground is, but like, it does get really, with the older trains,
with
it
Americans,
gets crazy.
We don't really have subways unless we're in the main cities like New York and Boston and whatnot. So
yeah, we don't,
I don't really
dug down here, they'd hit water.
Well,
we haven't changed anywhere except London.
Well, Doc, same thing goes over here. We don't have metros outside the city.
Yeah, but that's more of them.
That's why it's a subway.
Anyway.
It's a lot more common.
We don't have tubes outside London, do we? Well, maybe
we have... Nine. No,
well, it doesn't. We've gone way over an hour before. We've gone to an hour and a half before.
We've gone to 2 hours.
Yeah, but that was on purpose. Anyway, so next week's question of the week.
Next week's cuss of the week
is what makes you unique?
That's such a wholesome question. I like that one.
If I gave a scientific answer, would I be a dick?
Yes, you would
be a dick, yes.
As an introvert, I like to rehearse lots of typical, you know, social situations in my head, just so I don't panic when it happens. So one of the things was, one of the things I like to think about every now and then is, what happens if you're in class or whatever and you're told to, like, you know, explain yourself, like, you know, hi, I'm Nathan, and blank, blank, blank. So I would say, hi, I'm Nathan, I run an online community with almost 2,000 people in it. That's exactly what I'd say. So that's what makes me unique, I think. Just the
You're
fact that I
run
this place.
Aren't you?
And it has a fucking...
Braggadocious.
Well, no, it's not that. It's just I'm really boring
otherwise.
I have a
server and a girlfriend.
Look at me. I have, like, 2,000
people in my server. I'm literally boring as fuck otherwise. So that's the only thing.
What makes me unique is I have 65% oxygen, 18% carbon, 10% hydrogen, 3% nitrogen.
I heard you typing, you bastard.
No,
you
no, 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 no,
nitrogen, don't perform a human transportation.
1.5% calcium, 1.0 phosphorus, potassium 0.4, sulfur 0.3, sodium 0.2,
actually,
there's
only
0.3%
sulfur.
0.1 magnesium.
And thus, Full Metal Alchemist was born.
Wait a minute, dog. Are you reading this? Are you reading the script?
I heard him typing. I heard him typing while I was explaining mine. So he googled.
Oh yeah, I typed to people other than just this podcast. You know, I have friends.
But I won't say my dickish answer, and I'll say something else. The thing that makes me unique is probably my over analyzing every single situation down to the finest detail and knowing the hell out of everyone.
Okay, don't get me wrong. I can overanalyze as well, but nothing compared to what you do. Like, seriously.
That's my job every day.
This is not your job.
What makes me unique is nothing, because I'm not unique. I'm pretty average.
People call you dogs online.
Yeah.
People get called dogs online, but it's usually not meant as a name or more of a
I wouldn't call it speciality. I wouldn't call it special. It's just, you know, something I'm good at, but I am really good with history.
My dog, you could say I have a guy that laughs randomly in the background, and I'm very weird with my family. For example, when I answer the door,
that's like 300,000 people in America. That's like 300,000 people in America.
Well,
that's just America.
Well, it's...
Yeah. Pretty much.
Fine.
We are weird.
Okay.
Devils.
We broke away from
my unique.
Go devil, go.
Oh, God.
Go devil.
I don't know. I don't know what makes me unique.
I have
I'm not an existential crisis.
We're all unique. That's what makes us
you
the same.
Unique is you're a really chill dude until you get angry, and then you get really angry.
It's hilarious.
No, I don't really have a speciality.
I guess something that's unique about me is...
I'm gay as fuck.
Podcast with over two.
No, sorry.
That's a lot coming from a guy who talks about sucking men's penis a bunch.
Shut up.
Yeah, I don't know.
Shots fired.
I'm really trying to think what's unique about me, and I just cannot think of anything.
Your hair.
Yeah, welcome to my world, devil. Welcome to my world, devil.
Your name? Let's see.
No, I'm friends with Satan.
You're pretty fucking good at golf.
You have a butt plug permanently up your ass.
Hold on. Sorry that I didn't interrupt. Your name and your look. If you call that unique, then you have to do it 7 billion times.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. They're unique. Well,
I'm assuming unique is like random, where it repeats once in a while.
A name is not random.
Like, I guess I'm very... I'm very social online, but ask me to talk to someone outside of online, and I would just refuse, I guess. Actually, no, that's social anxiety.
That's pretty normal. That's pretty much everyone here.
We'll take it.
That's good enough. All right, so one more thing before we wrap up the podcast.
Wait, didn't Guadex say what is unique about him?
How did...
Guadex.
I don't know, because Nate doesn't notice me.
The guest!
Do you want to say something, Gorgon?
No, not really. Can't
pronounce anything. Okay, well, I was going to say...
Because nobody gets my name right.
Yeah, that's the thing. So one more thing before we finish the podcast. We are going to play one more game, and it is Writerfy. So earlier we played Wrongify, where we get really easy questions and you answer them incorrectly. And now we're going to do one where we answer them correctly. So
this is basically just a quiz.
Literally just an easy, really, really, really easy quiz. And we want to see who can do it.
Can I go first? I hate being last.
Okay, my dog, you can go first if you want.
Thank you.
Are you ready?
I like being embarrassed right away instead of waiting for it.
Yeah, I know how that feels. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, 3, 2, 1. What is rice cake made from?
Rice.
What color is a winner's medal?
What?
What color is a winner's medal?
I don't fucking know.
What color is a winner's medal? When you win gold. Yes.
Sorry, your accent is fucking annoying.
When you complete the fairy tale title, three little.
I don't know.
Okay.
Wow.
Who is the other half of the duo? Laurel and Blank.
Don't know.
Where's the capital of England?
Don't know.
Fuck off. How many sides does a rectangle have?
Jesus.
Huh?
How many sides does a rectangle have? Don't know.
4.
What do you use your tongue for?
Sucking.
How many legs does a worm have?
4?
It has 0, what the fuck? What do you put on cereal?
Sugar.
Okay, well, I think I messed up the scores of that one. But I think, because you said, I don't know, and that put me off. That threw me off completely. So it says you got 8, but I don't know if that's... Right, so I'm going to put 8 question mark.
Let's go with 3.
Okay, let's go with
3. I should say you got an even 2 cereal
one. I just want to point out, my neighbor has cranberry juice on his cereal, so...
I say sugar. I don't usually...
It could have been anything.
But yeah, but you put sugar on it, but you always put milk on it on top.
I don't put milk in my cereal.
Nice. What the fuck?
No, I have a mate who heats the cereal dry, and then he drinks the milk.
That's wrong.
I don't even have milk.
That's wrong.
I just eat it dry.
That's not wrong.
He also doesn't sleep with pillows. He's a strange guy.
Jesus.
Okay, Nathaniel.
Yes.
If it's not a hassle, could I go next?
Yes, you can go next, Devil. Thank you very much. Very politely asking. Are you ready? Burner, please mute your microphone when you were typing. Devil.
Oh, shit. Sorry.
3.
I am ready.
2, 1. Is a pear a fruit or a vegetable?
It's a fruit.
London is in which country?
England.
Who is the other half of the duo? Bonnie and...
Clyde.
What is the opposite of no?
Yes.
What part of the body do you wear a tie?
Neck.
New York is in which country?
USA.
Who makes spectacles?
Who make what?
Who makes spectacles?
I do.
Masters makers? Specsavers, why not?
Yeah. In which month is Halloween?
October.
Where's the main ingredient in milkshakes?
Milk.
Who is the other half of the duo, Tom and...
Jerry.
Which country is champagne associated with?
France.
What type of animal is on the Twitter logo?
Bird.
What shape is a Rubik's Cube?
A cube.
Name a girl's name beginning with S.
Sandra.
Okay, you just ran out there and you scored 13.
Hey!
Much better than my dog's 3.
When you said what's main ingredient in milkshake, the first thing that came to mind, shake.
Yeah. A lot of the ones you gave me though can be very perspective and opinionated.
That and you spoke sort of with a British accent, which was hard to understand.
Sorry. And okay, I'll take like names, this towards the end.
You can put any name with another name and it be correct. You can't say
it's okay, Graham Half. I'll talk like this for the end of the podcast.
I'm Canadian.
Are you very sure about that?
If you say A, I swear to God, I'll beat you.
Just say anyway. Maple syrup.
Try me.
Maple syrup. Okay, bud.
Maple syrup.
Okay, bud.
Maple syrup. Can I try?
How?
Can you try what?
Next.
Oh, yeah, of course you can.
Your pal, guys.
Are you ready?
I guess.
3, 2, 1. Name a James Bond actor.
I don't know.
Name a country in Africa.
I don't know.
For fuck's sake, what is the opposite of up?
Down.
Name a three-sided shape.
Triangle.
Complete the film title, Silence of the...
Lambs.
Name a shade of red.
Wrong.
Ruby.
Name a country with no vowels.
Fuck.
Which animal does foie gras come from?
What
animal does foie gras come from?
No idea what you're saying. Nah.
Fuck it up.
How many toes does the average person have?
I hope 10.
Which units do you measure weight in?
Kilograms.
Name something you would use to wash the dishes.
Chuck Norris's fist. Elephant.
Okay.
Triangles.
I think I fucked up on the scoring 32. Again.
32.
Grim.
A lot of these could be opinionated, though. You can't really...
Well, just say...
Well, I don't think a country in Africa can be...
I don't like right a five, because it's harder to answer right than it is wrong.
No, I agree about that.
Plus,
there are
you
ones
give me
where...
the two things I suck at. Movies, since I never had TV.
Yeah, I like that movie.
And
either.
Geography, because that was the other class I failed.
Okay.
Didn't he say Africa?
Yeah.
You could have just said South Africa.
I didn't think of that at all. I thought it was Africa. Africa, where is that exactly?
Africa is my favorite country.
And if it weren't for Team Africa, the U.S. would be Africa.
Like, when you say Africa, I think, oh, there's a cool place in Africa that's going to be gone soon because it's actually falling in on itself.
What?
Yeah, look it up. It's really creepy.
So
it's like
Florida.
Giant craters of just stuff falling in.
Like, where does it all go? Floor. Does it just fall to the bottom of the earth?
See, what happens is there are giant cavities underneath the land that are filled with water. Once the water is used up or dried up, it becomes an empty cab.
I thought it was because there's a tectonic plate that was in the middle.
That, too, can happen in Africa, but mm-hmm. a lot of the sinkholes that are happening right now are due to empty caves. Basically,
isn't that where the pit of fire is?
What? Which pit of fire? You mean the one in...
The one that never stopped burning.
Oh, that's in Pennsylvania.
That's in Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
I want to go there and just, like, smoke a cigar.
And then it got the Ring of Fire, which is the Asian Pacific Ocean.
No, anyway, that's not where they make pencils.
Right if I didn't really work out, so I'm guessing we're going to wrap up the podcast here.
Oh, yes.
Others might want to do it. I just don't like it.
I think we'll skip it. So, thank you to Burner, My Dog Devil, Gordex, Grimhoff, and myself.
Make sure to subscribe to Cryos Gaming.
Fuck off.
For joining us in
and
the podcast.
And make sure to remember, if you go into a pool, you're not getting wet.
My dog, to be honest, this podcast has been such a monstrosity that I doubt anyone's listening to this anymore. So, I mean, there's no point.
If anyone has reached this part, tag ping me. If you've reached this part in the podcast, back later on. Ping Devil Cyborg, and I will give you 500 Tatsumaki credits.
And a note for the next episode.
Why you fucking been here the whole time? He could just do it.
Yeah, I'm starting to think I shouldn't be in podcasts anymore.
No, Grim. You make the podcast fun.
But
anyway.
We got
nothing
so
fun like stabbing your eyes out.
thanks for Godix for supplying all the Pikachu weird fucking gifts. And we'll see you around. Say bye, everyone.
Bye. Later, alligator.